to online classes for BSc first semester. Enjoy every subject. So last class we have already discussed about the general characteristics of porifera. So today we have to continue that portion, that is classification of porifera. Phylum, right? So classification of phylum porifera. Last class we have already finished the general characteristics of porifera. Now is the classification of porifera. So the phylum porifera is divided into three classes. One is Cathecharia, then second one is Hexactinidia, and third one is Demospongia. So total the porifera is divided into three classes. One is Cathecharia, Hexactinidia and Demospongia. So this Cathecharia is not having any subclasses, same as in Hexactinidia is also not having any subclasses, but the Demospongia is having three subclasses. One is Tetractinidia, and second one is Monadzonida, and the third one subclass is Keratosa. So this is the classification of the phylum Porifera. So this Porifera is divided into three classes: Cathecharia, Hexactinidia and Demospongia. But the Demospongia is having three subclasses. One is Tetractinidia, Monadzonida and Keratosa. So first one will be the class Cathecharia. So what are the characteristics of Cathecharia? These are small sized animals. Means small sized calcareous porifera are present in these animals. These are small sized. The next one is body shape is cylindrical or vase like structure. These are small sized body is cylindrical and vase like structure present in these calcarea, and these are marine animals. You know already the marine means sea water animals. Calcareas are small size, some are cylindrical, some are vase like structure, and these are marine animals. These are below 10 cm height in the sea water. That is called as Cathecharia. So what is the example of this Cathecharia? The example is Cycon. Cycon is the animal that we include in Cathecharia. So these Cathecharia are small sized, these are cylindrical, some are vase like, and these are marine animals, and these are height in 10 cm height in the sea water. That is called as, the example is Cycon, that is the Cathecharia. The next one is Hexactinidia, that is another one class in Porifera, that is the Hexactinidia. So these are moderate size. What is the meaning of moderate size? Moderate size means little bit bigger than that of Cathecharia. That is a moderate, in a medium sized animals are present in these Hexactinidia. So that is called as moderate size animals are present in these Hexactinidia. And another one character, these are 1 meter in length. Then body shape is cup-like or vase-like. You know already vase-like. These are cup-like or vase-like animals are present in these Hexactinidia. And another one is, these are marine animals. Hexactinidia, these are marine animals in many deep sea waters. So this is the characteristics of Hexactinidia. These are small, but these are moderate sized. These are cylindrical and vase-like, but these are cup-like and vase-like structure. And these are also marine animals, and these are also marine animals. But here, the length of the animal is 1 centimeter length of the animal. So, which is the example of Exactinidia? That is a Hylonema. Hylonema is the example of this Exactinidia. Here, example is Cycon, and here is the Exactinidia example is Hylonema. The next third class is Demospongia. So, what are the characteristics of Demospongia? The characters are, these are small or large size. Both are present. Small or large size. Both animals are present in these Demospongia animals. Means Demospongia, some are small in size and some are large in size. The next is body is vase-like or cup-like structure. The body is vase-like or cup-like structure. And next is spicules. Spicules means, spicules are like this. The spicules are present in the body. These spicules are monadzone or tetradzone. Tetradzone. These spicules are single or maybe in tetra. Tetra means four. Spicules are one or tetra. Four are present in these Demospongia. Spicules are monadzone or tetradzone in these animals. But there is no triadzone in the Demospongia. The next one is, these are marine as well as freshwater. These are marine as well as freshwater animals. But in these two classes, these both are in marine. But in Demospongia, these are marine as well as freshwater animals. So, these are the common characteristics of Demospongia. One is, these are small or large, body is vase or cup-like, and spicules are monadzone and tetradzone, and these are marine and freshwater animals. So, depending upon these factors, Demospongia is divided into three subclasses. One is Tetractinidia, Monadzoneidia, and Keratosa. So, first one is Tetractinidia. So, what is the characteristics of these? These are spicules are tetra or absent. Before only I told what are the characteristics of Demospongia. So Tetractinidia are having four spicules or it may be absent. So that is the characteristics of Tetractinidia. The next one is body is flattened. Body is flattened or round in structure. Body is flattened or round in structure. Then next, these are dull bright color. These are dull. Dull means it will not having a strongest or darkened color. It is a dull color. That is a dull light color. Dull light colored animals. And mostly are shallow water. Shallow is also useful for the daily use purpose. That is, these are also shallow water animals. Shallow water animals. So, which is the example of this? Tetractinidia is Chondrila. Chondrila is the example of this type of Tetractinidia. So, what are the characteristics of these? These are spicules are four in numbers or it may be upside. The body is flattened or rounded in structure. And the color of these animals are dull light in color. And these are shallow water animals. So, that is the characteristics of Tetractinidia. And example is Chondrila. Then another one subclass is, that is a Monadzoneidia. So, that is Monadzoneidia. Spicules are monadzone. Monadzone means only one spicule is present in this monadzonite, and body form variable. Variable means it may be round or flat or any other structure. Means variable body structure is present in these animals. Then next, mostly shallow water These are shallow water, but some are in deep water, means sea water, deep water sea, or some are in fresh water, means these monads are monadzonidia is single spicule. That is, a monadzon spicule is present in these monadzonidia, and the body structure is variable in this structure. And the shallow water or deep water sea or fresh water is the aquatic animal from the monadzonidia. So it is the example of this monadzonidia, that is a halichondrilla. Halichondrilla. Halichondrilla is the example of monadzonaut. So there is a slight difference between these two. Here tetra spicules, here only one spicules. Here the body is flattened or round, but here they are variable. Here shallow water is only one color, only one water body, but here they are shallow water as well as fresh water as well as deep water sea waters. So here the chondrilla is the example. Here halichondrilla is the example of the monadzonidia. So there is a last subclass of keratosa. So this is having horny sponges. Horny sponges are present in these spicules. Horn. That one we have to see in any of the cattles. That is, a keratosa are having horny sponges. Spicules are present. The next one is body form usually rounded. Body form usually rounded and are dark colored animals. So that is the characteristics of keratosa. Keratosa character is, these are horny sponge spicules are present, and another one is the body is rounded and dark colored animals are present in these keratosa. So the example is Eusporangia. You maybe hear this name, that is Eusporangia. So this is the characteristics of classification Porifera with their example up to classes. So the main classification of Porifera divided in three class. One is Calcarea, Exactinidia, and Demospongia. But this Demospongia is having three different type of subclasses. These subclasses are depending and divided by the help of spicules. This Exactinidia is having four spicules. Monadzon is having only one spicule, and keratosa is horny sponges or spicules are present in this animal. So this is the classification of Porifera. In the next class we will continue this Porifera further.